Now let us see the students, trigonometry, because we have to make the use of this concept in this next topic. Next topic is resolution of a vector in two dimension plane. Actually we have studied earlier resolution of a vector in a plane, but at that time the vector components are not perpendicular. Here the vector components are perpendicular. So that is resolution of a vector in two-dimensional plane, or you can say resolution of a vector in terms of perpendicular vector components. But before that we see the little part of trigonometry. Here it is, one table is given. These are the theta values. These are the functions. Cos theta, that is cos 0 is 1. Cos 30 degrees is root 3 by 2. Cos 45 degrees is 1 upon root 2. Cos 60 degrees, 1 by 2. And cos 90 degrees is 0. Cos 180 degrees is minus 1. Sin theta, sin 0 is 0. Sin 30 degrees is 1 by 2, that is 0.5. Sin 45 is 1 upon root 2, sin 60 is root 3 by 2, sin 90 is plus 1, and sin 1 it is 0. So here what you have to study? You have studied this thing in lower standard. Now you know 2 pi radian is equal to 360 degrees. So pi radian equal to 180 degrees. Divide by 2 on both the sides. Pi by 2 radian will be 90 degrees. Again here you divide by 3, so pi by 3 radian will be 60 degrees. Divide by 4 on both the sides, pi by 4 will be 45 degrees. Divide by 6 on both the sides, pi by 6 is equal to 30 degrees. So in physics, either you can use the angle in terms of degree or in terms of radian. Here I take one value, sin 30 degrees. So this is sin 30. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. At the same time, you see the cos 60 is also 1 by 2. So I can write sin 30 equal to cos 60. Means sin pi by 6 equal to cos pi by 3. That is sin 30 equal to cos 60. Or you can write at the same time. Now let us see the sin 60. It is root 3 by 2. Sin cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So one can write sin 60 equal to cos 30. What's the relation between them? How can you write that sin equal to cos? If the difference of angle between them, right? If you are finding here, this is the 30 degree, this is 60 degree, the sum of these two angles will be 90 degree. Sum of these two angles, again this sum of these two angles will be 90 degree. So be remember, in case of the cos function and sin function, if there are two angles such that their sum is 90 degree, then they are always be equal. It means what? Sin 30 equal to cos 60. Sin 60 equal to cos 30. If you take here the sin 40, then there will be cos 50. Here if you take sin 20, then there will be cos 70. So actually here there is a one trigonometric functions. This trigonometric function is like this one. So this is called converting function. Sin function is converting into cos function. Sin pi by 2 minus theta equal to always cos theta. Or cos pi by 2 minus theta will be equal to sin theta. So here you can write this 30 equal to what? 90 minus 60. So this sin 30 can be written as sin 90 minus 60. So 90 ke alawa jo angle hai wo automatically becoming equal to what? Cos of that angle. So sin pi by 2 minus theta equal to, yahan pe theta that will be equal to cos theta. Cos pi by 2 minus theta will be equal to sin theta. So you can see here sin 30 equal to sin 90 degree minus 60. So that can be written as sin pi by 2 minus 60. And this sin function converting into cos becoming equal to cos 60. Similarly, sin 60 equal to, so 60 can be written as 90 minus 30. So sin 90 minus 30. But here as it is 90, so this sine function is converting into cos, and you will get this is equal to what? Cos of 30 degree. तो दस बी रिमेंबर साइन 90 डिग्री माइनस इक्वल कॉस थीटा एंड कॉस 90 डिग्री माइनस थीटा इक्वल टू साइन थीटा. तो दिस यू हैव टू यूज इन दिस टॉपिक. तो नाउ लेट अस सी द रिजोल्यूशन ऑफ ए वेक्टर इन टू डायमेंशन. दैट इज रिजोल्यूशन ऑफ ए वेक्टर इन टर्म्स ऑफ टू परपेंडिकुलर वेक्टर कंपोनेंट्स. तो हाउ इज इट. सो हियर आई हैव शोन वन डायग्राम टू डायमेंशन. Plane is there, this is x axis, this is y axis, this is origin. I am taking this is a vector OP equal to vector A. This vector OP is in xy plane. It is neither on x axis nor on y axis. It is lying in xy plane. That's why it must have two vector components. One vector component will be in x direction, another vector component will be in y direction. How will you obtain it? To consider vector OP equal to vector A lying in XY plane. Then from the head, that is from the point P, I draw two perpendicular lines. One perpendicular line is PM, which is perpendicular to X axis. Another perpendicular line is PN, which is perpendicular to Y axis. This perpendicular line cuts at a point M on X axis. Then measure the distance from O to N. Put an arrow at a point A, then at a point M, then you will get this is the vector OM. So this vector OM being in X direction, it is known as X component of vector A. It is denoted by the symbol vector A1. So vector OM can be written as vector A1. But as it is in X direction, instead of vector A1, you can write capital A suffix X along the X direction unit vector I. So AX is simply a number, and this number, that is the distance from O to M, and it is multiplied by the proper unit vector I. So you will get vector A1 equal to AXI is the X component of vector A in the X direction. At the same time, this another perpendicular line PN perpendicular to Y axis, it cuts at a point M. You measure the distance from O to M. Put the arrow at a point N, so you will get the vector ON. This vector ON is said to be vector A2. But instead of A2, you can write also, it is equal to, this MP will also be vector A2, equal to what? A suffix Y. So this AY is simply a number and it is a distance from O to N. It is a distance from O to N. So that's why AY, as it is in Y direction, in the Y direction we know the unit vector is G. So this number is multiplied by unit vector G, then AYG, or you can say vector A2, is another vector component. So thus we are getting the two vector component of this vector A. One along X direction is either A1, or you can write AXI. Another along Y direction is either A2, or you can write AYG. So now if we draw the two lines from the head of the vector A, which are perpendicular to x-axis and y-axis, as shown in figure, then we get the two vector components, one vector component vector OM equal to vector A1, and another vector component vector OM equal to vector A2, such that the resultant vector A equal to sum of these two vectors, vector A1 plus A2. You can check it. This is according to method of parallelogram. These are the two adjacent vectors, vector A1 and vector A2. From the origin O, OP is representing diagonal. So this diagonal vector A is representing as the sum of the two adjacent vectors. One is vector A1, another is A2. Also according to method of triangle, this is the first vector A1 from its head. This is another vector A2. By joining the tail of the first with the head of the second, you are getting resulting vector A. So this resulting vector A equal to A1 plus A2. But what is A1? A1 is parallel to x-axis. And what is A2? Vector A2 is parallel to y-axis. So we can write vector A1 equal to AX into I. We remember, this is the vector A and X is suffix. Remember, A into X is not there. Capital A suffix X. AX. AX is simply a number multiplied by proper unit vector of X axis. It was I. So here AX, singularly vector A2 equal to AYG. where Ex equal to On and Ay equal to On are simply real numbers and they are called as X and Y components of vector. So this Ex and Ay are known as X component and Y component of a given vector. Is that clear? But they are not a vector itself. When you multiply this Ex by proper unit vector I and Ay by proper unit vector j, then they will become the vector components. Otherwise, this is said to be simply components. So thus vector A equal to vector A1 plus vector A2 or vector A equal to Axi plus Ayj. Not that Ax and Ay are itself not a vector, but Axi and Ayj are vectors. Now we determine the value of these vector components by using the geometry of the figure. As you have seen in the earlier diagram, there was a vector A. It makes an angle theta with the x-axis. That's why there was a right angle triangle OPM. And we have to make the use of this right angle triangle OPM. Actually, this right angle triangle OPM was like this one. This is vector A. This is Axi vector. And this is Ayj vector. This is the angle theta is there. So, let theta is the angle made by this vector A. This was the x-axis. And this was the y-axis. As you can see, theta is the angle made by the vector A with x-axis, which shows, what shows? Direction. This vector A, neither in x direction nor in y direction, but it is in between the x direction and y direction. That means it is lying in xy plane. And in this xy plane, by making how much angle, it is there. So that angle is showing what? Direction. Which shows the direction of vector A with respect to x-axis. For this right angle triangle OPM, we apply the trigonometry cos theta equal to adjacent side upon hypotenuse. The adjacent side is OM, hypotenuse is OP. But now we write what is OP is magnitude of vector OP. What is OM is magnitude of vector OM. And magnitude of vector OM, that means it is simply a distance from O to M. And distance from O to M is AX. Similarly, the distance from O to P is magnitude of vector A. So it is denoted by simply symbol A. So thus cos theta equal to Ax upon A. It means A will be Ax equal to what? A into cos theta. So Ax equal to A into cos theta. Similarly, we apply the sine function. So sine theta equal to opposite side, it is Pm upon hypotenuse. So Pm upon OP is there. Again Pm is equivalent to vector Ayj. So its magnitude equal to simply Ay. We can write sin theta equal to Ay upon A. So Ay is equal to A sin theta. But instead of sin theta, I can write it is cos of 90 degree minus theta. So here it is cos theta, here it is cos 90 degree minus theta. Or you can write Ax equal to A cos theta, Ay is equal to A sin theta. So from this, you have a definition of the components of vector. So what's the definition? What is Ax equal to product of A and cos theta? What is A? A is magnitude of origin vector. And cos theta, cosine of the angle made by vector A with x-axis. So, which direction component chahiye, us direction mein. Vector A ke saath kitna angle banaya hai? Wo angle ka cosine angle. And multiply by magnitude of vector. Equal to kya milega aapko? Ax. Similarly, y direction ka component chahiye. To y direction ke saath kitna angle? तो यू सी इफ आई से अगर ये मान लो यहाँ पे 30 डिग्री है तो नेचुरल ये एंगल कितना मिलेगा आपको 60 डिग्री, यानी कि वेक्टर वाई एक्सिस के साथ कितना एंगल बनाएगा 60 डिग्री, 60 डिग्री यानी कि इन टर्म्स ऑफ 90 लिखना है तो इट इज 90 माइनस 30। अगर मैं ये थीटा कहता हूं तो ये कितना मिलेगा आपको 90 माइनस थीटा। तो ए वाई कॉम्पोनेंट क्या है, तो ए वाई कॉम्पोनेंट वाई डिरेक्शन में इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर ए इनटू कोसाइन ऑफ द एंगल मेड बाय दिस वेक्टर ए विथ वाई डिरेक्शन। तो वाई डिरेक्शन का एंगल कितना है 90 डिग्री माइनस थीटा। तो दस यू कैन सी दैट द कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ वेक्टर इन एनी गिवन डिरेक्शन इज इक्वल टू द प्रोडक्ट, किस किस का प्रोडक्ट, प्रोडक्ट ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दैट वेक्टर एंड कोसाइन ऑफ द एंगल मेड बाय दैट वेक्टर विथ दैट गिवन डिरेक्शन। यानी वेक्टर ए का कॉम्पोनेंट एक्स डिरेक्शन में चाहिए, तो वेक्टर ए में एक्स एक्सिस के साथ कितना एंगल बनाए वो, वेक्टर ए का वाई डिरेक्शन में आपको चाहिए तो वेक्टर ए में वाई डिरेक्शन के साथ कितना एंगल बनाया वो, तो इसका कोसाइन यानी कि मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ वेक्टर इनटू कोसाइन ऑफ द एंगल मेड बाय दैट वेक्टर विद दैट पर्टिकुलर डिरेक्शन। ऑल्सो द कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ ए वेक्टर बी रिमेंबर in any direction shows the effectiveness of that physical quantity in that particular direction. If I say this vector A is velocity vector, suppose, तो velocity vector के दो components, one is Vx, another is Vy. तो Vx component shows its effectiveness only in x direction. It is ineffective in y direction. Similarly, its y component, that is Vy, shows its effectiveness only in y direction. This vy component is ineffective in x direction. तो जो component है वो उसकी particular direction में effectiveness बताता है, दूसरी perpendicular direction में इसकी effectiveness zero है. तो thus also the component of a vector in any direction shows the effectiveness of that physical quantity in that particular direction only. One more thing. Components of a vector can be positive, negative or zero depending on the value of theta. अगर मान लो ये vector A instead of lying in xy plane, vector A lying in x direction, तो x direction के साथ है, तो angle A का, sorry, vector A का x direction के साथ angle कितना मिलेगा zero, and cos zero equal to one but sin zero is zero, मतलब क्या होगा कि इसका x component होगा लेकिन y component zero हो जाएगा। तो thus the components of a vector can be positive, negative or zero depending on the value of theta. I will explain this thing later on after this topic in detail. Now taking the ratio of these two components, Ay upon Ax, we get Ay upon Ax equal to A sin theta upon A cos theta. Sin upon cos is tangent theta, tangent theta equal to Ay upon Ax. Therefore, theta equal to tan inverse of Ay upon x gives the direction of vector A with respect to x-axis. So, vector A, x-axis ke saath kitna angle banata hai? So, that you can determine by using this formula. Theta equal to tan inverse of Ay upon x. Yani ke Ay kitna hai, Ax kitna hai, unka ratio aur uska tan inverse. So, that will give the angle theta. Then we determine the magnitude of this vector in terms of its component. Now, if you take the squares of these two components, so kya hoga? Ax square is a square cos square theta, Ay square is a square sin square theta. So, taking the sum of the squares of these components, we get Ax square plus Ay square equal to a square cos square theta plus a square sin square theta equal to a square in bracket. And as you know, cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1. So, Ax square plus Ay square equal to a square. It means what? Because of these two components are perpendicular, one in x direction, another in y direction, always the sum of the squares of these two perpendicular components, sum of the squares of these two perpendicular components is equal to square of the magnitude of the given vector. Therefore, vector A, magnitude of given vector equal to square root of Ax square plus Ay square. So, you can write modulus of vector A equal to this much, square root of Ax square plus Ay square. This thing I have written in words. Thus, the magnitude of given vector A is equal to the square root of the sum of the squares of these perpendicular vector components. Then, one more thing. Now, after this topic, यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट एनी वेक्टर बाय टू स्पेसिफिक मेथड्स और बाय टू स्पेसिफिक वेज. व्हिच आर द टू स्पेसिफिक वेज? नंबर वन, ए गिवन वेक्टर कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड एंड बाय डायरेक्शन. फॉर डायरेक्शन यू हैव टू सी हाउ मच इज द एंगल मेड बाय गिवन वेक्टर विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू सम रेफरेंस लाइन. एंड रेफरेंस लाइन फॉर टू डायमेंशनल प्लेन इज ऑलवेज एक्स एक्सिस और प्रोबेबली इट इज एक्स एक्सिस. तो देर आर टू वेज टू स्पेसिफाई वेक्टर ए इन ए प्लेन. इट कैन बी स्पेसिफाइड बाय नंबर वन इट्स मैग्नीट्यूड एंड द डिरेक्शन एंड द डिरेक्शन बाय एंगल थीटा मेड बाय इट विथ एक्स एक्सिस. एंड अनदर मेथड ऑफ रिप्रेजेंटिंग ए वेक्टर is in terms of two components, ax and ay, and you can write vector a equal what axi plus ayt. So that second is its components ax and ay. Now, be remember, if magnitude of vector a is given and theta is given, then ax and ay can be determined by using these equations, ax equal to a cos theta and ay equal to a sin theta. But if ax and ay are given to you, then magnitude of a vector can be determined by taking the square root of the sum of the squares, the sum of the ax square and ay square. And direction can be determined by using the formula theta equal to tan inverse of ay upon ax.